blow him to bloody pieces. Oh, I got you. Orkin.
Kyle. Is that you?
Yes, I'll try to help you.
No. Just listen. They're following us. Wanted the cure. Didn't know how to open. So asked about Mother. I told them nothing.
Don't talk. Save your energy. I'll get you out of here.
Lighthouse. Lighthouse.
Orkin, stay with me. Damn it. It's Crane. The bandits were in the granary. So was Orkin. They captured and tortured him.
Did he tell them anything?
I don't know. He said he didn't. He did try to tell me something about the cure. I guess they didn't know how to open it?
So some of it remains. Even though they spilled a lot at that field. You have any idea where they go?
Orkin said something about the lighthouse. I'll take a look.
Thank you, brother. If you find those vials, give us a sign immediately. You'll take it straight to the mother.
Hey, what's going on up there? Holy shit! Is that all you got?
Thank you. another
Lena! God damn it! Fuck, I'm so close.
Shit, it's you. Damn, I could have killed you.
Khan?
That's me. So turn me loose. Hey, what the fuck?
It was you. You're working with Ryze's bandits? Where is it, you son of a bitch? Where the hell is the cure?
What? You're crazy.
Don't fuck with me, Khan. Where is it?
Look, I just live here, all right? I don't know shit about working with bandits.
Boss, you there? Hello, can you hear me?
Who's speaking?
No need, pal. Just keep your eye on the balcony.
Wait! Wait!
Wait!
I know I went way overboard, but they forced me! They made me do it!
It's Crane! Crane's there!
Hawkins Group! Where are they heading? Tell me!
To the dam! The priest said the entrance was in the dam! Please!
I'm fucking done with you. Oh, shit!
Take him! Go! Now!
Find him! Show me the goddamn corpse!
Yeah, burn in hell, assholes. Oh, no. But this is Crane. Do you copy? The vials are gone. I saved only the last few of them, and Ryze's men are coming to you. Do you hear me?
Crane, come here fast. Come quickly.
Hello? Shit. I better hurry.
Thank you.
you!
trade? In a couple of minutes, I'll be packing my toys and heading out, and you won't fight me after that. Move, people, move!
Send new copy!
It worked!
We're on the other side!
And you wouldn't believe what's over here!
There's a big arena!
Guys? Guys, you're alive? Well, shit. Have fun on the other side. Hey, anybody there? Brother?
More fighting. More death. I can't let this happen again. I won't.
It's you. Where are the faceless? What's happening to me? Why do I hear your voice inside my head?
Children of the Sun, Kyle. They were nothing before the outbreak. Just a half-forgotten tradition. An old-world faith long dead. I'm tired. I've held this title for so long now. The Mother. It was meaningless. Until it became all too real. I thought their respect came simply because I was a colonel's wife. We had a good, cozy life. After the outbreak, my husband came to get me out. We didn't stand a chance against the Horde. We were bitten. He bled to death in my arms. He gave me his cigarette case and asked me to run. He didn't want to hurt me. I was dragged away by the relievers. They came for their mother. It took me a while to remember that my husband didn't smoke. I looked inside. There was a map, a key, and a note with numbers. It led us here. The healthy ones tried to get the power back on. The rest of us went to look for medicine. Pointless. Container. The numbers turned out to be a code. There were strange vials inside. The others looked to me. They could have held medicine. They could have held poison. I felt a seizure coming. I was about to turn, and I realized, why else would my husband leave me here? I loved him. I trusted him. Remember a taste. Acrid. Bitter as blood. It might have been blood. I awoke. Down there. Surrounded by the remains of the people who had trusted me. It was because of the light. Someone finally turned the power back on. And the light brought me back. You see, breathing the fumes is one thing, but drinking the liquid is something else entirely. In the light, in the sun, my mind is my own. I'm filled with love you couldn't possibly imagine. But in the dark, my new nature dominates. Mindless, lethal. In the dark, with cruel passion, I ripped my own children to pieces. But I swore to myself that I would become the mother they really deserve. Now, you have come, Kyle. And every sign tells me you're the one I've been waiting for. It's in the prophecy, Kyle. Then shall be revealed one man who, through an act of ultimate sacrifice, shall accept the mercy of the heart. And the God of the Son shall be revealed through him. And through him will he speak.
I just need that medicine to save my friends.
Look at my face. There is no medicine. You want mankind to become what I am? Listen to my voice. Beautiful evolution indeed. Minds and souls connected in a telepathic bond. How poetic. Look at me. And when the darkness comes, what then? More death, more killing. You can hide from others, but who will hide them from you?
But we don't have to drink it with just the mist.
It doesn't matter. Just listen. You've been breathing the mist. It will take longer, but you're already changing into a monster such as myself.
No, wait. Listen.
The army built a failsafe into their experiment. This entire region can be purified. The question is, are you ready to sacrifice thousands of lives, Kyle? Yours among them?
So what, that's it? Just game over. Fuck. All right. So what do I do?
Wake up the God of the Sun. Follow me, Kyle.
So the coming of your God means, what, we all die? And the plague, it dies with us?
It always meant that. And he shall pass through the gates of death, so that he may bring new life.
If it kills the plague, I mean, I guess it's worth it. This place doesn't look much like the gates of death to me, though.
Flowery language, isn't it? I was searching for proof, Kyle. For truth in our traditions. But Attila's death shattered my hopes. It was proof.
What, that there are no miracles?
What's a miracle anyway, Kyle? Becoming a sentient volatile? I'm nothing more than a monster. Becoming a hero during the apocalypse? You're just the right man in the right place.
So this is the failsafe. What do you need me for?
The key I got from my husband worked, but the codes he gave me didn't. I know that's the only way. I just don't know how.
Codes? No, your husband, he had a failsafe too. He left the codes with Attila, so he could decide if you'd stay sane long enough to make a decision.
Wait! You have the codes? Attila thought you'd be a better judge. I hope you'll judge me well, then. Let this madness end, Kyle. Please.
Thank you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.